Hello everybody, Torgal here, and welcome back to my Let's Play series. Last time we got a bunch of saddles from the Nether, so I decided to set out today and get a few horses and bring them home. You guys might remember that I mentioned I found brown horses when I was looking for sheep, and I already got one of them. Ooh, it's set come night. Let me sleep here real quick when I can. There we go. And I instantly, you know, I got one of them brown horses and put a saddle on, and there is so much plains biome and stuff in the area that I decided to just go around and check out the place a little more. I didn't find anything interesting, but I found a group of black horses, and over there is white horses. So I figured we're gonna get us the brown one. I do have a couple more leads, so I think I'm going to get one of these all black horses. Let's get this one right here. And then, ooh, he dismounted me quick. And I think I want to get this black and white one here. And then we're going to get two more from over there. I want to get two and two here because the brown ones are much closer to the ocean. So those are going to be easier for me to pick up. And then I'm going to see if I can get all these guys back there. And then comes the next thing, and I want to show you this here when I get back towards the base. I took one of the rivers, and it actually got me besides the very last part all the way to the ocean. It's winding there, and I want to show you guys that because we could make a canal, like a water canal, kind of like a river. Did he have hearts yet? Yeah, cool. All right, so we got one of them here. What? Oh, I got a dismount, of course. Hey, come with me, buddy. I'm gonna put you over here next to the brown one. Oh, wait a second. I gotta do it like this. Let's put this one here. Can you only put... Can you only put one at a fence post at a time? How does this work here, buddy? Excuse me, can you please? What is happening? There we go. That was weird. I thought I did it right. Huh. And I was hoping that I'm going to be able to put one of the horses in the boat. Just like we had the success with the cows. Let me put the other ones here. And then can ride it home that way. So how many more do I have? Four more. So I can, on my way home, get another brown one. Then I would have two brown, two black, and two white ones. I think that would be perfect. All right, so I want to get this guy right here in the water. So anyways, let me go ahead and tame all these guys up. And then I'm going to start making my way back to the brown ones. And then I'll show you guys that water canal that I was talking about. I got them all here, guys, to the ocean. Right here is where we're gonna set out, and then the jungle is just over there where I want to get to. But I wanted to show you a glitch that I found, and I'm pretty sure I made a note already so I don't forget after I'm done recording right now. I want to report that to Mojang because that is a giant pain in the butt. This is horrible. These guys get stuck on everything when they're on a lead now, and I hope I can replicate this right here. Watch, when you just run them up, see that? A one high, they don't come anymore. They're stuck. So what I actually needed to do was I needed to bring the first one over here with a saddle, and then I leashed it up. And then I got the saddle back, ran all the way back through. It's luckily it's only plains biome, so it's a straight shot to where I got these guys from. And it's also nice because then I can get more if I want to. But yeah, then I got the next one with the saddle, rode it here, ran back on foot over and over until I have them all six here or five. And then I tamed the last brown one right over there. I think I can show you guys. Yeah, there they are. There's one, two, three, four more. So the brown ones are here and the black and white. Over there is just a very thin strip of forest and 50 blocks tops. And then beyond that, the plains biome continues. And then you straight shot and then you hit the black and the white horses. So It wasn't that bad, but still, that's definitely a bug or a glitch that these guys cannot walk up a one high when they're on follow. That makes no sense, okay? So, now, here's the thing. I believe I can get one horse in the boat, okay? And why don't we try that real quick? Maybe I can run it in on with the saddle. That'd actually be... Oh, but then I might have a problem that when I need to break the boat that I'm gonna hurt it. But we can try it. So can you get in here? You're just gonna stand on top? Okay. And it's in. Very cool. I think I'm not even gonna get these guys on the lead to follow me. I'm just gonna ride these guys one by one over to where I wanna bring them. Can I still get in? Yes. Okay. So let me... Oh, I'm on the horse. Hehe. I want to get in the boat, please, horse. Oh, that's going to be a problem. A big problem. What if I click here, still on the horse? Ay, ay, ay. Okay, so I think I need to be in the boat first and then maybe drive it or ride it over that one. Sorry, horse. Oh, that's going to be... Big problem. No. Oh my goodness. I don't want to hurt the horse anymore. And that sucks. How am I going to get him out of this now? I should have made a backup. This horse is terrible. So it's okay if I need to kill it. There's more brown ones. But this one and the... All white one are so slow, these two. The other four are somewhat the same speed to me, so I don't know. I do have bread on me. I can feed them in case, but this sucks. I mean, come on, make the hitbox so... Let's see. No, still hitting the horse. Okay, so that tells me actually what I need to do. Oh, that sucks. Any other way of hitting this boat out hitting the horse? No. Ah, well, guys, I'm sorry, but this horse needs to die, I guess. And I'm just gonna get another brown one. But at least I have it on camera. I cannot think of any other way of doing that. Can I push the boat further to shore, maybe? No? Okay, what if I stand up here somewhere? No. Well, that sucks. Oh, did I get the saddle back? Yes. Oh, man, I did not think that through. So, what I am going to do, though, now is... Sorry, horsey, I feel really terrible, but... Okay, now I got the squid in here. So now I should not have a problem with... having something on a lead follow me. I don't have another lead. Okay. So I am going to... Sorry, guys. Get one more here. Alright, so let's start with the other brown one, because those are the ones I can get easiest right here, in case something else goes wrong on my testing here. So now you come on a lead and follow me. I'm going to do just one right now, and I want to show you where I'm going to bring them. So, are you going to follow me at least here? Yes, okay. So, let me show you guys real quick. I'm not going to watch you guys right the whole way, but I'm going over here to the left now. I'm going to follow the shore, and then you can see what I have prepared on the other side. So that's it. It's about a minute ride with the boat, and you guys remember that very first day, that's where we made the first boat on this little sand island here. And I prepared a little horse stable here because I'm happy to get them all this close, because from here I could ride them one by one with the saddle over there. Not that I really want to do that, because I think there's going to be easier ways to do it. Alright, you follow me, good sir. Sorry, I had to kill your cousin. Don't tell me he got in the boat. You gotta be kidding me.
I just risked it. I'm sorry. I'm so glad it didn't die. But this is a joke, right? Man. All right, come in here. All right, how are you doing on life, buddy? I hit you once with the sword. Oh, he seems to be doing good. All right, so here's where I got them. And I'm gonna bring all the other ones here also, of course. But I wanted to show you real quick, right over here. Because this is something I would like to do today, because it's gonna make it so easy exploring this way. And along the ocean. It's gonna take a little bit of landscaping. But we can make this water canal here. It's really not a lot of work. Right here, I need to excavate this. And then fill up this cave entrance here somehow. So it goes that way, following the terrain. And I gotta be careful. And then over here, we're gonna excavate this a little bit. Maybe we'll use this waterfall feature here. And we're just gonna have to follow this right here, just to this spot right there. Right over here. This is how far. And this is probably... I got the coordinates of my cave right here. Let's see here. We're at... So the X is about the same, 40 blocks difference. And the Z is... Yeah, we are pretty much 450 blocks from home. And you can follow this river. Yeah, it's snaking through here, but it's still very easy to follow. You know, certain spots here and there, we're going to have to widen a little bit. It gets a little narrow, so it's hard to turn. But that is something I would like to do once I get all the horses over here. Because then I can simply bring the horses, I hope, the same way home. Or maybe I'm going to run the horses home. I don't know yet. Because I want to get all the horses home, just so we can breed them. And then, like I said, maybe make a little racetrack to figure out which is the fastest ones and start breeding them, if we can. But right now, I'm going to bring all the other horses over here the same way I just did. Hopefully, I don't need to... I don't know how I'm going to do it. Like, I'm going to possibly... Check it out. When I come back with the next one, I'm going to come up with the boat right here. I'm going to come this way and stop right there. So the horse is going to be somewhere just behind me. Hop out and run straight back here so the horse follows me on shore, hopefully. Who knows if that's going to work. But anyways, guys, I'll be back once I got all the horses in the stable here. And I am going to bring one more brown one to replace the one that I just had to kill. I'm so sad. I'll see you guys in a sec. A little bit of time has passed because I did a lot of landscaping that I'm going to show you here in a second. And I did record some of it, but I thought it was very boring. So I thought I'd just rather show you guys the end product. And we spent some time today building horse stables. I think that would be much cooler. So here's the six horses. And this is just temporary, this bridge here. I also made a tunnel through this little bit of dirt here. Thinking that maybe this way I'm going to be able to ride the horses easy. And you'll see in a second that riding them home is actually not going to be too hard. So what I'm going to do here when I showed you the canal, I'm going to drive the boat here, break it, of course, take it with me, and then take a horse and ride it back, come back with the boat over and over because, well, the glitch with them falling on the lead is just not going to work. And I think this snakes too much for them to follow me on a lead when I'm in the boat. But I was telling you that I, this canal right here. Now, right here at the beginning, the very straight part, I had to break through myself. The river did not come to here. And right now it looks very plain, but in the future sometime, I'm gonna dress this up and make like a retaining wall out of stone bricks or something. So it looks like a man-made canal, right? But let's just drive this all the way back to the base so you guys can see it once. And over here was natural, right there. So this right here, I needed to break through also. And that is it. From here on, all the way back to the base, it was natural river. So right here, I just did a little bit of shaving to make it wider so it's easier to navigate. So wherever you see the grass is where I built it for now. And this right here, had just a few lights every once in a while because at night it looks really cool. And that way there's a few intersections where I want to make sure... Whoops. I'm having still problems navigating. At a few intersections there, I still have more lights because that way I know which way to go. So right here, you guys can see we're on the border between the extreme hills and the jungle. And we just keep following these torches. And it's about, I don't know, 2 to 3 minute ride in the boat, so it's not bad at all. Over here, I left the trees. This is just a lagoon here. Over here, I left the trees, even though I might regret this in the future. Ah, I miss the old boat, Smice. I really do. It would have been so much easier to steer here. Maybe I just need more practice. Here it opens up a lot, just like in the area where we live. And this is where I also have torches, so I know which way to go. See, this oversteering is, I think, what bugs me the most. If I want to go left and then press it, and then you steer back a little bit to the right. I wish that was more snappy. The only way you can really do is if you completely get the boat to a still stand and then start again, then it does not overturn. But oh well, nothing I can do, right? Here we have a really sharp turn. I shaved a lot off here to make a little wider just so it's easier to navigate. And it's really cool. I love it. Guys, I did more landscaping also around the base. Ooh, a little bed here. I forgot to pick that one up. I'll get it in a second. And it's pretty amazing in a jungle how much landscaping and stuff you need to do to get something done. Holy shnikes. So right here, you guys see, there is that ladder from the first day. And I just want to have a stop here because you guys see this? I did not see this cobblestone back here until I got out of the boat and actually placed this pillar and I noticed it. And I want to go there. It's a jungle temple. Now, the thing is that I'm used to going into a jungle temple and just destroying the walls and getting everything, right? This time, I would actually like to try to figure out the redstone that's in there. Where's actually the entrance? I came back here and the creeper messed with me, so I had to fix that up. Ah, here's the entrance. Okay. So, let's just light this place up. So we have... Actually, you know what? While I'm in here, I'm going to put this there. So we cannot have any surprises come from behind. And let's keep lighting this up. Because I don't know how long it's going to take me to figure out this redstone on the inside. Sorry, I got the sniffles. I'm trying not to do it too much into the microphone. So there's the three lever thing that we're going to figure out in a second. First, I want to disable all the traps. There's a dispenser right there. There's the string. So, what did this guy do? I'm gonna take these with me for sure. There's another one. So, how does this one get triggered? There must be redstone underneath here that goes... Ah, right there. It comes out from there and then it was a shot us. Okay. Let's see what's in this guy. Nothing. You guys see, I got a ton of clay from working on the... on the river, shaving it and stuff. I think it's okay to disable the trap, yeah. And give me all the redstone. But I'm gonna fix this back up the way it was, good. And there's another trap for this dispenser. All right, let's get more light here. And what do we have in you? Nothing either. On a multiplayer server, I would have said somebody else was here. Okay, I don't need seeds, saplings, or apples. But I do want to take the gold. Don't care about the bones. Or this stuff. We'll leave that here for now. Actually, anything else I can leave here? Ah, I'll be fine. Okay, so this right here is from this trap right there. So I can remove this redstone also. and put this. How was this just now? Right there, right? I think so. Something like that. All right, so three levers back here. There's some kind of a combination you need to do, and then it opens. I don't even know where it opens. Let's see. I heard a piston. Didn't see anything opening. Nothing. Nothing. Double piston. Where is this supposed to open? I don't know. Is it open something on the top? No. We'll put a torch here. Actually, let's put here. Okay. Don't know what's supposed to happen here. It took me way longer than I expected, and I don't know how I did it, but the block that moves is right down here. And this middle one doesn't do anything in anything I tried, but apparently the last and the first one, this one didn't do anything right now. But now if I use this one also, now it's closed again. All right, let's see here. Undo this one and undo this one. Let's see. Now it's open, and I decided to now break this here so we can actually take a look at this redstone and see what it does. So break through here. Yeah, I really want to figure this out, guys, and you guys might like it too. So let's take this first one. So that one extends these two, and then the other one pushes. That's probably this first one then. So, okay. So how do I get it back to the original position? Probably now if I pull this one back. I'm guessing you cannot. That's weird. So you cannot pull an extended piston. Okay. All right, well, here it is, guys. That's funny. I am going to take these pistons with me, of course. Free pistons, I'll go for it. And a little bit of redstone. And what do we got in here? Okay. That's a lot of gold. 22 gold. That is really nice. Because gold is not easy to come by. All right. And I am going to close up the hole up here. So if I come back for something in the future, I don't just fall in and give it a light. So, yeah. So we got our jungle temple done, guys. I like it. I can't believe I couldn't figure this out for so long. But I think the main problem was that I didn't know to look here to see what's going on. I was running around everywhere and I could never figure out where something is supposed to happen. But we got it. So I'm going to head back to the house now. And gonna get started with the horse stables, because I don't want to get the horses back until we are actually done with the horse stables, because I want to be able to put them somewhere. And also the skeleton horses, I still haven't tried those out yet. I wanted to do that with you guys, of course. So I'll see you in just a second. So I started the excavation process. I've been at it for about an hour and a half now. I can't believe how much land I needed to move. When you look at the jungle like this, you don't really know how much dirt and stuff there is, right? To give you an idea. This is everything I took down from over there so far, and all this wood is from collecting from here. Besides the spruce, those was the two spruce trees here. And the actual stables with the courtyard is, from what I planned on doing, about 30 by 28. You'll see why it's a not even number later. But I noticed that it's a little bit shifted too far from the left. I don't know why I'm picking up the saplings. Sorry. I have so many. Because, well, over here, it's very close. I wanted to make sure that I have something around the building. But the building is going to go to here, right? But that leaves a huge place over here. So we might have to build something over here or maybe make a little garden or something like that. Oh, yeah, maybe a wheat garden. So for the horses, for the hay bales and stuff. But over here, this, you know, I just cut straight through after I counted it. Let me show you if I can get over there. The building ends right here in this line. And I did one more, so in case I need to walk around or something, I can do that. And I figured I'm gonna get all this prepared. I gotta take down all this stone here and then on here fill all this with grass, replace all this stuff here. And then when that is done, we're gonna start building the actual stables. And this back here, I'm gonna leave for another day, the landscaping. I don't just wanna have a straight cut through, right? But I wanna finish the building first to get a better idea of what it looks like against the backdrop and stuff. I think that makes more sense than, you know, landscaping everything and then building the house. So let me continue this. Probably gonna take me another 20 minutes or so. You guys can see my shovel is... I used up this entire durability, over half of the durability, just here on all this dirt. That's pretty bonkers. Anyways, just wanted to give you a quick update, and I'll be back in just a second. Oh, I just finished doing all the... Oh, man, I forgot one piece of dirt up there. You gotta be kidding me. But I got it laid out or marked out with the cobble, and there's actually a reason why I want the cobble here. And that is so later on, I'm gonna have some dirt in here, in the stables, and I don't want the grass to spread. So I figured I'm gonna put the cobble here, and that should stop it. And all I'm gonna do right now is just lay out the base of all the stables, and then it's gonna give you guys an idea of what I'm going for. I believe I counted we're gonna have 17, I think. There's gonna be 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, and 5, yeah. 17 actual stables, or whatever you want to call that. And then we're also gonna have the big courtyard here in the middle where, you know, we can have roaming horses and whatnot. So that's kind of what I'm going for. And right here is where I'm gonna have the dirt later, but we're gonna fix that in a little bit the way I want it. Actually... Oh boy, guys, my UPS just started beeping. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, but that means I need to shut down my computer. We have storms going on, so I might actually be out of power in this room. I'm gonna have to check, and I'll BRB. And it's the next day. Yeah, I had some power issues in the house last night with the storms. So I just decided to shut down and go to bed. It wasn't very early for me anyway, so it was a good thing that it happened. And I just wanted to show you that I dug one more underneath the wood here. Because I was thinking that if I leave dirt down here, that this grass might spread to over here. I'm not exactly sure how grass spreading actually works. I should probably look into that one day to figure it out. And let's do... I'm getting here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 8 and this is 6 wide. And then here I'm gonna have the same way. Stables. Another... Oh, actually, what do you call them inside? I think this whole thing is a corral in the courtyard here. What do you call that in the stables? Is that a cell? A stable cell? I don't know what you call that. So there's 5. And then again, we're gonna have 6 here, and then 8 here. And then again, more of the cells. I'm just gonna call it cells. I don't know what you call it. I'm sure one of you guys is gonna tell me. I hope you will. All right, and then we need one here, 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 and here. And then there's, of course, more stuff going on later. I see that sometimes the blocks Like, now I got it. What happened to the dirt that was in here? I don't know. That's something I noticed before that. And that seems to be in the snapshots, that sometimes I believe we actually lose a block. I don't know where it goes to. You know, if there was a glass block or something nearby, then I would know that it's getting pushed into it. Right, I can finish the fences here before night. Actually, am I going to have... Yeah, I'm going to have fences there. So these are the in-betweens. I still need to do the wall on the back. Let me finish this mirror side here real quick. So all the stalls are laid out. That's right. I said the correct term. This is considered a stall inside the stables. I looked it up on Wikipedia. I don't like when I don't know what something is called. I don't want to call it the incorrect term. And now all I'm going to do here is pull up all these spruce woods, the logs, all the way up to 4. And guys, you might wonder, why am I choosing spruce instead of jungle? Being in the jungle? Because, well, I'm not a big fan of what the actual jungle wood looks like. When it's growing on a tree like this, it looks good. But let me just show you, in case you guys are wondering. It's just not a very nice wood, if you think about it. Let me put this in contrast right next to it. It's sideways instead of vertical, the grain or whatever, the bark. And I don't know, it's too much to me. It looks good for a palm tree and maybe like a palm hut or fishing hut or something. But if you have this everywhere, it's too overwhelming. And I think that when I choose the spruce wood, which is also my favorite wood to play with in Minecraft, dark oak is my second favorite, probably. I love those. But it gives it a nice contrast. You know, everything has this golden and green look inside the jungle. And the grass is very, very green. I like it, you know, compared over here to the river. That looks like... Bleh. I don't like this grass here at all in the river biome. But it's okay. I mean, I guess it works here. Because it shows a difference between the river and the jungle. But anyway, that's the reason why... Man, that was a lot of explanation why I like spruce wood better. It just looks better to me. So I'm going to pull all these up to 4 height. And is this 4? Yes. Okay, I don't want to mess this up. And then... Yes, the other thing I'm also going to do here real quick. That's all just, you know, grind work. Is I'm going to place a pumpkin jack-o'-lantern into the corners on each one of them. They're going to be barely noticeable, but they're going to make it bright enough that in none of these stalls I need any extra lighting. It's going to get the light level above. Let's check here real quick on F3. Look at the block, not the actual light, because it's going to tell you 15, but the block 10, 11, 11. So it doesn't go down below 10, so... No chance for anything to ever spawn in here. And because I haven't really figured out yet how I'm going to do the lighting out here. But we'll tinker with that once this is done. I'm going to light the whole place up. Bring up all these spruce pillars to 4 now. And yep, then we get started with the roof already. All the spruce wood is pulled up to the correct height. And out here, we are just going to have fence. This is just so nothing can run in. And I wanted to have, oops, not over here. Here we're going to do something else later. But I did not want to have a fully enclosed stable. Because, well, you know, they're horses. They're smelly. You got to make sure you got enough fresh air going on in here. Did this one place? Yes. And this one we're not going to do. And you guys see that ring of leaves I put around. Now, that is just for me to build. This has nothing. It's not staying there, guys. No worries. But it's gonna make it very easy to place the roof. I don't like roofs. Okay? I don't think I'm good at them. And I hate placing roofs. It's simple as that. I actually have to make some here. I just took down another big spruce wood spruce tree because I didn't have any more. I should be fine. So let's make a ton of stairs. We're just gonna make a stair roof. Here's my thinking, guys. Through the entire series, when I build something, I want to get it done first. And then, you know, over the course of the next days, weeks, whatever, we can always refine buildings. So it's not like that once I'm done with a building, that's it. I hope that makes sense. So these right here, what they allow me to do is I can just go around and place these stairs like that. And then when I am done with that outer ring and inner ring completely, what I can do then, let me get some more leaves here, is get up here and actually get one more, and then I can actually walk on these stairs and place the other ones right on top here. I just like that, and I don't care about, you know, destroying the leaves afterwards. I might get shears and make it easier on myself to take it down or whatever, but this is just something that I like to do, and it's easy. It makes it so much easier. If you're up here and you're like, you know, carefully one after another placing against each and so on, it takes so much longer. And this way I just got a nice little scaffold going on here that helps me place them. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish that up. Actually, you know what, I'm gonna just show you guys what I have planned for the top, because I don't want to cut too many time. I don't have any more spruce wood, dang it. I'm just gonna use this one here real quick. I'll replace it in a second. I just want to show you what I'm gonna do on the top so I can finish it all at once, and we can actually do something with the horses for the rest of the episode. And that is, I'm also gonna need wool, and I'm gonna make all 64. And how many is this gonna give me? Times 3. Okay, it might not be enough, but we'll see. Let me sleep real quick, because on top of the ceiling, there's gonna be spawning spots, and I don't want to put lighting up there. And I believe that carpet stops spawning. I'm pretty sure it does. I should probably. Why is there a leaf block, miss? Oh, that's not leaf. That's the wood. Hey, I'm pretty sure that carpet stops spawning, but I'm gonna double check just to make sure after I'm done. And then right here, we are going to have the slabs like this. Right here on this one, of course, it cannot spawn because that is the bottom slab. And here. All right. And then we are gonna need... I just need to place this one again. That's fine. So like this. And finish off the roof just like this. I'll show you from the front in a second. Did I really just fall down? Wow. All right. And then on the top, because here is the spawning spots, stuff can spawn up here. I figured we're going to try out the brown carpet and see what that looks like all the way around. Let's see. I mean, you're not even going to be able to see it from the bottom. And, well, until we get a glider or something, it's going to take forever. Can we see it from up here? No. Barely. And even if we could, it's brown. I think it's okay. It could almost be like a kind of a mud paste or something like that that was placed up there, you know, to insulate or to seal the roof so it cannot leak water in and so on. Anyways, I'm gonna need to grow another spruce tree real quick and get more spruce wood. And actually, this goes over here. And I'm gonna finish off the roof now. So when we are done there, what's happening? Why am I misclicking so much today? I hate these ones because it takes me forever to place the ladders to get up to the top. Here it's not bad, but once you're on the ladder and you hold shift, it takes so long to break these leaf blocks. Anyways, guys, enough talking. I'm gonna finish the roof, and then we can go ahead and dress it up the whole building, and then we can finally move our horses in. Oh, that's what the roof looks like. It is so straight and clean. It definitely needs a lot of work. I want this to be, I don't know, look more older, banged up, so we're definitely gonna have to play around with this a lot. But as I mentioned earlier, I want to get builds done, and then we can spend time, you know, throughout the episodes, dressing it up and making it look more realistic, if you can say anything realistic in Minecraft. But I pulled up the fence here, got rid of all the leaves. By the way, question for you guys, can you tell the difference between these two leaf blocks? I don't see a difference. This is oak leaves and this is acacia leaves. They look exactly the same to me. So actually, what happens when I pick them up? They're gonna show them both. Yeah, see, acacia leaves. So there's no difference to me, but whatever. And I needed all these acacia doors because I wanna... We're already really late into the episode, guys. I wanna close this off now and get the horses in here. That's what I'd like to get done today. And then when that is done, next episode or whenever, we can then start playing around with, you know, dressing this up, looking it better. There's a couple decorations and lighting ideas that I have for this, especially in the middle here. For right now, I'm actually just going to place torches because I want to make sure that nothing spawns in here. That's it. Let's just place a few here. It doesn't really matter because they're going to go away soon. But just so my horses are safe, I don't want them to get killed or something. Good. So the other thing is that I want to do here still today, that's something I want to get done. And that is, can I actually do this and then place the doors? No, I cannot. Okay. So this right here needs to be something else. And I wonder what we're going to use for that. Let's see here real quick what spruce wood planks would look like. That's the same as up here. Do I have any jungle wood on me? Ooh. Let's try acacia wood because I made these doors, the acacia doors, because I think they're the most fitting for this place. I like that. I think we're going to leave that. And that's just so these doors here, they look like, you know, bars. And if you look at stalls from horses, they usually have a metal gate with bars so you can look in, they can stick their nose out or whatever. Well, this is as close as we can get. I was thinking of making something like piston doors, but honestly, there is not enough room here in these stalls to have piston doors. I won't have the room for the redstone. So I'm just gonna go like this for now. I think that doesn't look bad. Okay, and then the other thing is I want to get done, and that is the whole reason why I planted this cobblestone in the cells here. I want to use this right there, the whatever this is called, the dirt road or whatever. And between the stalls, I wanted to just have dirt, okay? Just like this for now. So I'm going to go around and do all that in the different stalls, and I'm going to get the horses over here. I want to get this done today. I want to have them in here tonight when I'm editing this video. And in the end, we're going to get the skeleton horses out. And I want to write this one on camera today and see how cool it is. So I'm going to get busy here with fixing up all these stalls the way we just did over here. And of course, guys, if you have any screenshots or any comments, recommendation, please take the minute and go down in the comments and let me know. I really want to dress this up. We're going to do a lot with horses in this series. Back here, for example, I was thinking we might put the racetrack. That's why I'm glad I did not landscape this yet. So we'll figure that out. Anyways, I'll be back in just a second. All the horses are in their stalls. It was a nightmare. I'm not going to lie. It was a nightmare getting all these guys here. Ow, don't run into a cactus. So we definitely need to make roads. There's just no way around it, I think. But I wanted to show you guys one other thing that I'm going to be putting here today. How am I going to do this? I think I'm going to need some leaf blocks or something. Oh, maybe dirt. I don't think I have any leaves here anymore. I do. Perfect. Because I need something so I can place this one upside down. Right here. One more. I saw this here once. I don't remember where. And I figured this would be really cool as windows, so we don't need to have the, you know, same height windows, you know, when you just make a box around it or something. I think these look much cooler the way they are. Let me just finish the whole thing here. And I just wanted to show you guys what they're going to look like. And then I'm going to duplicate it on the other side later. Actually, I only need one leaf block, I think. Yeah, I should be able to place it like this. There we go. And then I can place this one. And I need one more over. Yeah. Yeah. I've never made windows like this. But this is cool because, you know, it's 1.5. Nothing can get in. And it gives us something back here. This back here is gonna be the, I don't know what you might call it, like the breeding room or whatever. I don't like this entrance here. I still have to figure out what I want to do here, because it almost looks like a, it looks Asian to me, doesn't it? I mean, I don't get me wrong. I love Asian buildings and stuff, but I don't think it fits with this stables here. Maybe I can find out how to make this look Asian. Who knows? But anyway, so all these guys are in their stalls. And yeah, back here, we're going to have these two. Of course, I'm going to finish this wall over here the same way as this. That's why I made this 6 wide. So I can do the same over here. But I'll do this in a minute off camera. It's going to be done quickly. Because I want to get the skelly horses over here now. And I got some other stuff here. I want to enchant. One should be enough. I made a bunch more leads today because I kept losing them. Like they just despawned after they broke. I couldn't find some of them anymore. I actually needed to come back and get more leads. Alright, so how am I gonna get these guys out of here? Probably right there. I should be able to ride one up. So let's see. Alright, so they do not have armor. I have 13 hearts. Nice speed. Very nice speed. And let's see what we look like on this guy. Oh, I can see from the side. That sucks. Oh well, but it looks good. It seems to be quite fast. So I'm going to get all three of these in here. And I think those special ones we're just going to put back here. Yeah, and you just need to close one door. So when you get off, where do you go? He cannot run outside. You can leave one side always open. I don't know. I closed them over here, all of them for now. And I'm going to get the other two skelly horses. I just wanted to check real quick, get on the second one with you guys. So I do think they all have the same stats, these skelly horses. There's no difference between them. Holy shnikes! Famous last words. Are you kidding me? That's 26 hearts. Wait, is the other one just hurt, or... Holy moly, 26 hearts. This is a beast. Now we gotta try the last one. I don't know what is happening. That is a lot of health. So the middle one has 26. The first one had 13, right? That's what I said. Alright, let's get the last one. This one has 10. Give me a second here. I do have bread on me. I think with... I thought that you can feed these guys. Shift right click. No, do I need to throw it at him? Hey, you want this bread? I thought that they eat bread. It's eating something. Not sure. That's why I made this initially, this bread, because I know that you cannot feed them wheat anymore. At least that's what it said under the horse page on the wiki. Oh, by the way, carpet. I did check out the wiki. And it says something really weird about carpet. I don't know why they formulated it that way. But I'm going to read that to you guys real quick. No, I closed it. It said something along the lines of that carpet takes the characteristics of the blocks underneath. So if you, for example, place carpet on glass, then nothing can spawn on it and so on. And then I actually googled, hey, what blocks mobs cannot spawn on? And I instantly stumbled across a post again about carpet. And they said that nothing can spawn on carpet, and other people were chiming in, and I just could not get a definite answer. So I made a creative world, I made a dark room, and simply waited for mobs to spawn, and then I took the same room and put carpet on it, and watched it for like 10 minutes, and no mobs ever spawned in it. So I'm pretty sure that nothing can spawn on carpet. I did read that possibly if you have mob aggro, meaning that, you know, when you hit a zombie and other zombies spawn, that those possibly can. I believe those can spawn, but I don't care about that. I just don't want anything passively spawning there. And I turn this guy on because I want to enchant something here, because I've been having the 32 levels for a while, and you guys see I also brought a different fishing rod, because I would really like to try getting Luck of the Sea. Because it would be cool to enchant a fishing rod to get Luck of the Sea, because I want to do more fishing. Reason that I can get name tags, and I can also get more saddles from fishing. Let's see. Unbreaking 3. Let's see first here. Oh, I never showed you guys. I did 2 more boots. And this one has Depth Strider again. And this one had Depth Strider. What is it with me? These two I had, and then I got another Depth Strider. All I want is Feather Falling. I cannot get Feather Falling boots for the life of me. What do we get here? Blast Protection. Helmet. Oh, Aqua Affinity would actually be nice. Book. Bane of Anthropods. And Sword Smite 4. No, I don't want that. And I'm gonna risk the fishing rod, guys. Let's see. Unbreaking 3 and Lure 2. Okay. So, that is it for today, guys. I'm gonna keep enchanting a little bit. I think I'm gonna make a few more fishing rods. And then hopefully get eventually at the Luck of the Sea. The lure, from what I understand, is it makes you get bites on your lure quicker. And the Luck of the Sea just increases the treasure that you can get. So you have, like, I'm making up these numbers, okay? When you cast something, let's say you have a 80% chance to get a fish and 20% chance to get something from the treasure loot table. And the treasure loot table has enchanted bows, name tags, sticks, and stuff like that. And I believe that the Luck of the Sea increases your chances of getting more treasures, and that's why I really want that. What is the other one I have up here? I think I have Lure 2 or Lure 3 on the one I have up here. And that's the last thing we're gonna check. I have Lure 2, so I might combine these two. All right, anyways, guys, I hope you had fun and enjoyed the episode, and I can't wait to hear your feedback on the stables and, you know, tips and tricks. I'd love to get your feedback on it. And otherwise, I'll talk to you in the next one. Take care, stay safe, and bye-bye.